the finals of the Men and Women African Cup of Nations, it's always frenetic. On days such as this, there are no tribes, no religion. Here, Nigerian warriors are round to represent, to show the skills that makes us the best. On days like this, the color is one. The color is green. When we get the job done, it is because we have stuck together. When we celebrate, we stand together. Nigerians, united in victory. We are Nigerians. We are one.
The music of my childhood was completely British and American.
So my signature tune is pretty much
Robbers, they rob, they no see you.
And like you said, I'm robbers, rob, they no see you. They no see me, my brother. It happened to me.
Many, many months and many years and come and go.
Baba God, we say thank you.
So music is the way that the whole world can connect.
Sometimes music goes with comedy. I love music.
The love for music keep burning in you.
Music and Art, a must watch.
Hold on, please. Let me calm down.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I think we need to be able to hold ourselves to account a great deal more. And I think that the standards of accountability have to rise.
Nigeria gets pat on the back for the fight against corruption as Vice President Oshibajo stresses the need for accountability.
I support the fight against corruption, Mr. President.
National Assembly reacts to the swoop on judiciary officers for alleged corrupt practices. Plus, investing in the girl child resonates as the world marks Girl Child Day. Welcome to NTA Network News with me, Muhammad Kudu Abubakar. Nigeria has again received a pat on the back over its efforts and determination to get rid of corruption and institute good governance in the country. This was at the 46th conference of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of Nigeria, ICAN, where Vice President Yemi Oshibajo again reminded every Nigerian of the need to be accountable. State House correspondent Jide Onifade reports.
I'm very pleased to be here, and also...
While declining open the conference, Vice President Yemi Oshibajo, who notes that things were never done in the past because there was no one to hold accountable and targets not met, says the president has set the target of creating a better environment for doing business and for achieving goals. He says raising the standard for measuring performance and accountability would be of immense benefit to the nation.
I think we need to be able to hold ourselves to account a great deal more. And I think that the standards of accountability have to rise. Part of the reason is that everyone depends on financial advice. Everyone depends on the advice of professionals. The administration of justice is a public resource. Courts are a public resource. They're not a private resource. Judges, lawyers must be held to account for processing cases and for the time that they process cases. Otherwise, it becomes impossible for the administration of justice to deliver the results that are required for everybody's use.
We are working very much with the profession. We know
it is all about trust and being accountable to the people, as the finance minister Kemi Adeosun explains to participants at this ICAN conference on what government is doing to put the economy back on track.
We're doing two things. We're reducing that recurrent expenditure to try and keep it within our actual revenues. But the borrowing is for capital projects. The borrowing is for capital projects. We cannot afford to wait for the oil price to recover before we fix power.
President of the International Federation of Accountants commends the federal government for towing the line of honor.
Accountability Now Nigeria, which is the theme of this 46th annual Accountants Conference, is evidence of your commitment to play a key role in public sector governance, transparency, and accountability.
You must be responsible for your action. That's what accountability is all about.
More than 3,000 participants from Nigeria and some other African countries have attended the conference. From the International Conference Center, Abuja, Jide Onifade, NTA News.
Meanwhile, professional accountants in Nigeria say they will intensify their support to the Buhari administration's fight against corruption. Head of the Civil Service of the Federation, Winifred Oyo Ita, who is one of the accountants honored at the first ICAN Ambassadors celebration, said Nigeria's economic challenges will soon turn around for good.
The role of accountants in the economic development of any nation, observers say, is critical to its overall development. Taking cognizance of the role these professionals play, especially in the areas of accountability and support for the present administration's fight against corruption, the president of ICAN, Titus Chuetan, says they deserve commendation.
These behavioral elements are no doubt urgently required in the change mantra that will prepare Nigeria to a better future.
The recipients received various categories of awards, with the head of the Civil Service of the Federation getting the Special Award of Excellence.
It is important for the members of the Institute to be part and parcel of governance. And that's why from this moment henceforth, we believe that you're going to see much changes, a difference in attitude, service delivery.
It is no difficult in taking decision as a professional accountant, because you use to map out a lot of variables.
The award recipients assure that they are ready to turn the nation's current economic recession into economic prosperity. Adebola, Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
The Senate has added its voice to the arrest of some judicial officers in Nigeria. National Assembly correspondent Waziri Zayanu reports that while pledging total support for the fight against corruption, senators frowned at the arrests.
Raising a matter of urgent importance, Senator Joshua Lidani noted with concern that principles of law have not been observed while sanctity of separation of powers has not been respected.
The DSS has abandoned its primary responsibility of prevention and detection of crimes against internal security.
All contributors affirmed that the law enforcement agents have outstepped their bounds by abusing their mandates. In a related development, President Muhammadu Buhari has requested the Senate to consider and confirm nominations of two judges as justices of the Supreme Court. Senate President Bukola Saraki read the letter conveying the request after the Senate returned from a closed-door session on Tuesday. The nominated judges are Sidi Bagi, Nasarawa North for North Central, and Paul Joro, Taraba State for Northeast. Senator Peter Nwamushe presented a report of the Committee on Niger Delta on the screening of the nominations of chairman and members of the Niger Delta Development Commission.
The committee resolved to conduct an open screening and to be guided by the Enabling Act.
The plenary went into a committee of the whole to consider the report. A consolidated motion was also sponsored by Senator Mustafa Bukar and Senator Andy Ubah on the urgent need to stop the plan to raise a federal government secured bond of 309 billion naira to finance the shortfall in the Nigerian electricity market.
Aware that the DISCOs, which collect revenues, have so far refused to fully pay other market participants, while NEC, which is the regulator, has failed to intervene by stopping this practice.
The Nigerian power sector is currently facing acute liquidity crisis.
From the National Assembly, Waziri Zayanu, NTA News.
Still on the fight against corruption, the House of Representatives has resolved to investigate the legality of all cases of persons arrested on allegations of corruption by the Department of State Services, DSS. National Assembly correspondent Ignatius Unko reports.
Citing the recent arrest of some judges by DSS, Representative Kingsley Chinda from Rivers State urged the House to interface with the security agency for more understanding of its constitutional roles as contained in the National Security Agency Act of 1986.
Some have relied on relevant laws, saying that they are empowered, particularly when you have a search warrant. What is the statutory function of this organization?
Now, when there's an allegation that the law of the land has been breached, I think we are the one, as custodians, as makers of this law, to determine whether there's a provision of any law that has been breached.
The urgent need for the federal government to develop a national plan for the prevention and control of cervical cancer was adopted as moved by Representative Saheed Fijabi from Oyo State.
Like the developed world, screening of cervical cancer is free, which, Mr. Speaker, it should be. It should apply to our nation as well.
As far as cervical cancer goes, it is the one cancer that is preventable.
In our homes and our villages, who doesn't know it? What they need is education.
That all the Federal Ministry of Education to carry out cancer screening tests in all the secondary schools in the Federation. Hence, early detection and immunization remains the best solution.
Members passed for second reading a bill for an act to amend the Fiscal Responsibility Act of 2007, which seeks to make it mandatory for states to put in place democratically elected local government council before such states can access funds from the capital market, as sponsored by Representative Edward Pojok from Plateau State.
I'm saying it should be more, there should be participation by other tiers of government in this matter.
The House in the Committee of the Whole approved the report of its Committee on Ethics and Privileges and Foreign Affairs, which cleared three of its members accused of sexual misconduct by the United States government. From the National Assembly, Ignatius Nkwo, NTA News.
Minister of Justice and Attorney General of the Federation, Abubakar Malami, SAN, says nobody, no matter how highly placed, will be spared from investigation in the current fight against corruption. He stated this at the inauguration of a committee for the implementation of the United Nations Convention Against Corruption and Assets Recovery in Abuja. Aliyu Tukur has details.
The Minister of Justice emphasized that the recent arrest of the judicial officers is in line with relevant provisions of the criminal procedures. He added that even those that are conferred with immunity, the right to investigate has not been taken away.
I think the undertone should be exclusively that of the consideration of the existence of a prima facie case, the existence of reasonable grounds for suspicion of a commission of offense. And if they do, neither the executive nor the legislature nor judiciary can definitely be exempted.
The committee is to review the implementation of the United Nations Convention Against Corruption, with emphasis on chapters 2 and 5 of the convention relating to preventive measures against corruption in public and private sectors and recovery of stolen assets, as well as effective management of looted funds.
So what we will do is to get the figures together, get the laws together, and then face the United Nations to establish our own case with them towards the review.
The review is expected to assist state parties the effective implementation of the convention, which has 180 members, and Nigeria is a signatory in Abuja. Aliyu Tukur, NTA News.
Inspector General of Police Ibrahim Idris has reiterated his commitment to enhancing police professionalism through training and retraining of officers and men. He stated this at a meeting with Assistant Inspectors General of Police, AIGs, and Commissioners of Police, CPs, at the force headquarters, Abuja. Joseph Johnson reports.
Addressing a wide range of issues bordering on professionalism, the IGP, Ibrahim Idris, was emphatic that capacity building for police officers, among other components, will improve their performances, particularly the Special Anti-Robbery Squad, SARS. He urged all AIGs and CPs to brace up, as there will be a restructuring of the police squad protection units.
We are doing everything possible to ensure that the perception of SARS improves. These trainings are part of our measures. Every commission of police should get us a facility in your command, liaise with the state governor to get a facility, even if it can take up to 200, I'm sure 200 men, so that the CTU to have a base.
The IGP also deliberated on establishing a maritime academy in Bayelsa State and Border Patrol School in Zaria in collaboration with Italian government. Joseph Johnson, NTA News.
Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, has expressed satisfaction with the pace at which the Abuja Digital Switchover project is progressing. The minister made this remark after inspecting facilities at the Pinnacles Communication, one of the three licensed signal distribution companies in Abuja. Anthony Folsom reports.
On the hills of Umpape in the Federal Capital Territory is the location for Pinnacle Communications transmission site, one of the signal distributors. With civil work almost completed, the project consultant explained to the minister that installation of equipment will commence soon. He assured the minister that with the feasibility studies already carried out to facilitate test transmission, he was optimistic that residents of the Federal Capital Territory and environs will receive clean signals while a conducive environment is being worked out for the comfort of staff. The minister had earlier visited the Pinnacle Warehouse where equipment procured for installation are being housed. Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of Pinnacle Communication, Lucky Omolua, told the minister that Pinnacle is fully ready to meet its obligations as all equipment needed for the takeoff have been procured and awaiting installation. Lai Mohammed, however, applauded the determination on the part of Pinnacle to ensure that the digital switchover is successful.
We are quite impressed that before the end of November, this facility will be ready to distribute signal to the entire FCT.
At Trophonics Electronic Company, one of the set-top box manufacturing company also in Abuja, the minister was told how the company has been able to meet its mandate because it has complied with the idea of using homegrown technology to drive the process. In the words of the minister, the company has lived above board.
We are impressed that this particular facility has capacity to run six lines, even though they are running only one line, because they've finished the work we gave, the job we gave them.
The minister further charged other stakeholders within the line of the digital switchover process to work assiduously in meeting the 2017 deadline. In Abuja, Anthony Forson, NTA News.
The federal government has developed and launched a national e-agricultural portal to serve as one-stop shop for agricultural content for all the relevant partners in government's programs. The platform was designed by the Federal Ministry of Agriculture in collaboration with the Federal Ministry of Communications. Musa Baba Ali reports.
The National e-Agriculture Web Portal is identified as a strategic initiative designed to enhance knowledge flow between policymakers, farmers and investors to ensure the robust development of the agricultural sector. The platform is to gather information and showcase all aspects of food and agriculture industry value chain in the country.
The National e-Agriculture Portal will give farmers information about weather, improved agricultural technology, new farming methods and techniques,
which will be a one-stop shop, you know, where anybody who wants to do agribusiness, not only agriculture, you know, agribusiness, can, you know, log into.
Meanwhile, the Minister of Agriculture will push for the review of veterinary laws in the country to pave way for positive impact on the livestock development for economic growth.
Similarly, we need to promulgate laws to enhance abattoir operations and safe meat production, processing, delivery and marketing.
This, the Minister of State for Agriculture, Henneke Lokobiri, said will be achieved in partnership with Veterinary Medical Association of Nigeria. In Abuja, Musa Baba Aliyu, NTA News.
Contractors handling the dollarization of the Kano-Maiduguri Road project have remobilized to site following the recent payment by the federal government. Works and Housing correspondent Muhammad Hamza Sheikh, just back from the northeast, reports that road infrastructural development is now progressing in the region after about 4 years of unrest.
Contract for the dualization of the Kano-Maiduguri Road was first awarded in 2006, but due to two main reasons, the insecurity in the northeast and the non-payment of contractors, this project has suffered a great deal. Now that peace is back in the Northeast and that contractors have been paid, work has started in earnest.
The Kano-Maiduguri Road is a trans-Saharan road of great economic and social importance to the people, not only in the northeastern part of Nigeria, but the entire North and Eastern Africa. The dualization of the road comprises the construction of additional carriageway, reconstruction of the existing one, including the construction and rehabilitation of bridges, culverts, as well as junctions.
The additional carriageway has been substantially completed, except for some sections that have some compensation issues.
From this April till now, they have been able to do almost more than 10 kilometers worth of wearing costs.
The project actually now is being run by the Nigerian local staffs, supervised by the Chinese.
The project is divided into five sections, with each section being handled by a different contractor. On each of the sections, work has reached between 30 and 49% completion.
We are satisfied with his progress.
Contractors handling the project say with continued peace being enjoyed in the Northeast, the projects will be completed according to contractual agreement. Muhammad Hamza Sheikh, NTA News.
Empowerment and investing in the girl child are key to breaking the cycle of discrimination, violence and non-protection of their rights. Minister of Women Affairs Aisha Jumwe Alhassan stated these in Kaduna at a briefing to mark the 2016 International Day of the Girl Child. Tina Toro reports.
The International Day of the Girl Child has the theme, Girls' Progress is Equal to Girls' Progress. A global girl data movement draws attention on existing gaps in data on girls and young women, lack of systematic analysis and limited use of existing data, which limits the ability to monitor and communicate the well-being and progress of girls in the society. The need for goals to better the lives of girls in Nigeria by providing an opportunity for them to reach their full potential is of paramount importance, especially at a time when girls in Nigeria are facing challenges through molestation and rape, as well as insurgency, which has crippled their ability to lead fulfilled lives.
The increased level of child and child molestation and rape, we have the VAP Act advocacy. So we are putting all our efforts going around the states to talk with the legislators, talk with the traditional rulers, talk with the government to make sure that they domesticate the VAP Act, which is a very protective mechanism for girls especially and women and children.
Only when investments in programs for girls on issues that particularly affect them due to their age and gender are complemented with corresponding investments can Nigeria make real progress in protecting their rights. In Kaduna, Tina Turu, NTA News.
Following the historic consensus by members of the Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, to cut production to between 32.5 to 33 million barrels per day band, there is a high indication of a convergence of views on the oil market. OPEC Secretary General Dr. Mohamed Sanusi Barikindo, after a consultation with industrialized consuming nations at the just concluded IMF World Bank meeting in Washington, D.C., said there is now a common understanding on the need for all producers to cooperate on a general cut likely to rebalance the oil market. Energy correspondent Hawasaliu Adama reports that in continuation of this effort, OPEC members will on Wednesday hold an informal meeting with non-OPEC producers in Istanbul, Turkey, for further discussions. The meeting is also expected to erect the building blocks for the implementation of the Algiers Accord of OPEC. President Muhammadu Buhari has congratulated former Director General of the Nigerian Television Authority, NTA, Engineer Vincent Maduka, who is 81st, who is celebrating his 81st birthday. In a personal letter to the celebrant, President Buhari praised his dedicated and dignified service to the nation during his years in the public service. The president added that throughout Maduka's tenure as DG of the NTA, he behaved decently and stayed above controversy. A quality, President Buhari noted, is rare among those exposed to the corrupting influence of power in public service. The president described the media professional as a role model who invested his intellect and energy to the selfless service of Nigeria. He prayed God Almighty to grant him more good health and wisdom in the coming years. You can watch this news live online via the NTA mobile app, which you can download on your Android device at the Google Play Store or at the Apple Store if you use devices with iOS. Still to come, INEC partners Federal Road Safety Commission towards conduct of the Ondo State Governorship election. Find out these after these messages.
When has it reached this? Much less this. And this. And this. And this. Help reclaim our commonwealth. Lend your support to the fight against corruption for a better Nigeria.
Once in a generation, a technology emerges that transforms a nation. Glo's new 4G network is exactly that. It is by far the fastest mobile internet in Nigeria and the first with nationwide coverage. Government institutions and big business will have the tools they need to build the powerhouse of Africa. Small business will be enabled to make the big leap. Medical procedures will be more advanced, and your home will become truly smart. With our most extensive national optic fiber network linked seamlessly to Glo One submarine cable, it is data speed and capacity beyond imagination. 4G will accelerate Nigeria's progress into the Super League, and everyone will see their lives change beyond recognition. The wait is over. Welcome to 4G LTE from Glo. Welcome to the new speed of life.
BASE University Abuja offers world-class education, uninterrupted academic session, and promising degrees for a sustainable job. BASE University Abuja is affordable and delivers quality with experienced international staff, superb facilities, overseas external examiners, and a serene academic atmosphere. We offer quality and affordable education, and students are within easy reach of their parents here at BASE University Abuja. So learn to live at BASE University for a brighter future. For more information, visit our website at www.baseuniversity.edu.ng or call 081-3376-9657 or 081-3376-9658. BASE University Abuja. Learn to live.
The family of Okon has been taken hostage by an evil-looking creature.
The thing just show for night. Yeah, be where?
Come in. My sister, I was there. What was happening in the news?
We must suddenly brought back your family.
You think you can free them? No way.
When Amatem fought appear, Malaria run for cover. Amatem. Thank you. Amatem fought against some jail capsules, tablets for adults, and suspension for Pekin. Amatem that does not eat somebody and are very easy to use. Are you? Remember how Amatem fought against crash pin to confirm the original and against some jail capsules. Amatem. Say no to malaria. Yes to life.
There is a reason Africa is called the New Frontier.
What was once potential is now an opportunity ready to be seized. Once revered for our resources, today's wealth lies in our people. People who build the cities that shape the future. People who know an idea in one place means business in another. A generation for whom technology means there are no borders, no boundaries. We are the new lions in a brave new world. Kings of the urban jungle. And there's a bank that puts the world in our pocket and the future in our hands. UBA, Africa's global bank.
Whenever pain occurs, you want quick relief. Try new Nurofen Express. It goes to the source of pain and gets to work in under 15 minutes. That's why Nurofen Express delivers fast and effective relief. New Nurofen Express. Works at the source of pain. Fast.
Being a mom is great, but when your child has a fever, you don't know what to do. I trust Nurofen for Children to take care of my child's pain and fever.
Effective relief you can trust.
The Vice Chancellor of Ambrose Ali University, EPOMA, Professor I.A. Onimawo, on behalf of the Governing Council, Senate, staff, and students of the university, cordially invites the graduates of 2013-2014 and 2014-2015 academic session and the general public to the 20th convocation ceremony of Ambrose Ali University. Order of events, Thursday, 20th October 2016, convocation lecture. Topic, the politics and economics of establishing a new university. Ambrose Ali University, EPOMA, has a case study. Convocation lecturer, Dr. Robson Momo. Time, 2 p.m. Venue, Reverend Chris Oyakhilome Auditorium. Friday, 21st October 2016, award of prizes, conferment of first degrees, diplomas, and certificates. Saturday, 22nd October 2016, award of higher degrees and honorary degrees. Come and be part of the celebrations of this great university. Signed, C.M. Adamaibo, KSC Registrar.
Thank you for remaining with the largest television network, the NTA. The All Progressives Congress four-member fact-finding committee established to look into the leadership dispute in the Kano State chapter of the party has submitted its report to the national leadership of the party. The APC National Vice Chairman Northwest, Inua Abdelkader, received the report on behalf of the National Chairman, John Odige Oyegun. Nelly Atumbi reports.
The chairman of the fact-finding committee, Senator Mohammed Maguru, said the committee looked into the propriety of the removal of some of the ESCO members of the party in Kano State. He said the committee discovered that all the procedures required in line with the party's constitution were followed in the removal of two ESCO members in the Kano State chapter of the party.
The Kano State Executive Committee followed the process.
APC National Vice Chairman Northwest, Inua Abdelkader, who received the report, declined comment on it, stating that the report was for the consideration of the appropriate party organ to take a decision. The four-man fact-finding committee was set up by the national leadership of the party following the removal of the chairman and the organizing secretary of the party in Kano State. In Abuja, Dele Atumbi, NTA News.
The Federal Roads Safety Commission and the Independent National Electoral Commission are strengthening partnership towards achieving a successful Ondo State governorship election and subsequent exercises in the country. This was the agreement reached at a meeting between the co-marshal of the FRSC, Boboye Oyemi, and INEC chairman, Professor Mahmoud Yakubu, at the FRSC headquarters in Abuja. Oyemi Ajayi has details.
The INEC chairman, Professor Mahmoud Yakubu, said he is at the FRSC headquarters to appreciate the call for the support given to the commission during the just-concluded governorship polls in Edo State. To this end, INEC is seeking for same logistic support for the Ondo State governorship election.
We should also borrow a leaf from what we are doing to see how we can make the processes of collation and transmission of results after election speedy.
The election coming up on the 26th of November next month, the operations are ready. We've reviewed the last election and I've given them the go-ahead. Like I told them, whatever logistic support should be in place, just call Oboid or the operations. We are here.
FRC Commercial reassured Nigerians of the commitment of the FRC to ensuring total compliance to traffic rules and safety on Nigerian roads. In Abuja, Oyeyemi Ajayi, NTA News.
As the two-day annual Pan-Northern Group Summit comes to an end in Kaduna, speakers have proffered solutions to the myriad of challenges confronting the region with a view to catching up with the rest of the country in all facets of development. Ibrahim Bellagunda reports.
The two-day summit mobilized sons and daughters of Northern Nigeria and other like minds to provide a viable, constructive platform of presenting a common and unifying position and a blueprint that will address questions of national development. Speakers at the summit took turn to present papers on unity, faith, peace, and development as they affect the North since May 2015. The call for restructuring Nigeria and how the North should respond and manage the current economic recession were exhaustively discussed by the speakers.
The immediate consolation which I can proffer is that Nigeria's problems are not insurmountable. You need a wing. The RAY Research Development Project is a very good wing. Issue of agenda, issue of strategic planning is an issue that is knowledge-based.
Because I'm a minority, I must be given my rights. I must be protected. My views must be heard.
On what Northern Nigeria stand to gain from the summit, some of the participants shed more light.
And you can't have unity unless you have stability and peace.
We want to address the issues at a summit like this nature so that other parts of Nigeria could also gain from our suggestions on various remedies to take.
The consensus is that Northerners should see themselves as one, irrespective of religious, tribal or political party affiliation, and work for the development of the region. In Kaduna, Ibrahim Bellagunda, NTA News.
Minister of State for Petroleum Resources, Ibe Kachiku, says Nigeria will soon surmount the challenges of crude oil theft, pipeline vandalism and bunkering. Helen Dunku reports that the minister also advocated the culture of one family, one company. This was at the 16th convocation of the Petroleum Training Institute, where more than 3,000 students graduated.
The convocation ceremony kicked off with a tour of the exhibition of products by the Minister of Petroleum Resources, Ibe Kachiku. The minister commended the judicious utilization of funds by the Petroleum Development Trust Fund, PTDF, in the upgrade of the Petroleum Training Institution.
Both for the institution and for the individuals, you got to begin to look inward. We're too helplessly dependent on the government system, and I don't know why. And yet, we're probably one of the most educated populations we have. But we are nostalgically getting lazy because we think somebody else will play our roles.
I wish to appeal to the federal government to consider increasing the budgetary allocation with the institute to enable it achieve its mandate.
PTI in collaboration with the Vist University, that is the University of the Vist Mother Tribe in South Africa, we commence the postgraduate diploma program relevant to the oil and gas sector.
Certificates of honor were given to deserving lecturers and some outstanding students. The three overall best students in the ordinary national diploma received scholarship to acquire the higher diploma certificates. And the overall higher national diploma graduates were offered automatic employment with the Ministry of Petroleum Resources. The Petroleum Training Institutes have the statutory responsibility of providing skilled personnel for oil and gas institutions in the country. In Warri, Helen Dunku, NTA News.
Still in the euphoria of Nigeria at 56, a festival tagged Rhythm of Hope, Festival of Arts and Culture, took place in Abuja and centered on reminders for Nigeria's diverse culture to harness oneness and keeping faith with peace. Bosede Ebel now reports.
The festival highlighted the richness of Nigeria's delicacies, crafts, theater, music, and dance. The works pass across the message of national unity in diversity, rebuilding of the nation and diversifying the economy away from oil.
This is an amalgam of festivity using going from west to wealth.
These things can be sold to any person because you can see how beautiful they are.
The audience cut across various strata of society, particularly art lovers from near and far, who truly expressed their admiration for the beautiful collections.
And I'm
the brain
proud.
Behind this initiative, Zara Muhammadu Buhari, believes that with the mind-blowing performances and exhibition of made-in-Nigerian products, great talents abound in the country and should be encouraged.
Rhythm of Hope Festival of Arts and Culture has made dreams come true, has empowered and created job opportunities, has brought together different tribes and relegated our differences. The aim is for Rhythm of Hope to continue to do so nationally and internationally.
With such an event over, it is hoped that Nigerians would patronize made-in-Nigerian products the more within the context of change. In Abuja, Bosede Abel, NTA News.
Another batch of Nigerians returned from Libya. This and more with Ademola Adeoye in our Lagos Network Center. Hello, Ademola. Tell us more.
Good evening and welcome to Lagos. The National Emergency Management Agency, NEMA, has appealed to the National Orientation Agency and state governments to intensify their campaigns against Nigerian youths who are in the habit of seeking greener pasture in foreign lands through illegal means. Director of Research and Rescue of the National Emergency Management Agency, Air Commodore Mohammed Salisu, said this while receiving a total number of 154 Nigerians at the Murtala Mohammed International Airport who voluntarily returned home from Libya.
Another set of 154 Nigerians have returned from Libya a few weeks after more than 200 of them voluntarily returned to the country. They were received by officials of the National Emergency Management Agency, NEMA, and other government agencies at the Murtala Mohammed International Airport, Lagos. Receiving the returnees, the Director of Search and Rescue, NEMA, Air Commodore Mohammed Salisu, said the cost implication of such programs is huge for the government. He condemned the idea of vulnerable Nigerian youths constantly endangering their lives in their quest for a better life abroad.
We encourage states and the National Orientation Agency to do more of this job because their mandate fits into this properly, to educate the Nigerian citizens, particularly these young girls, on the danger of crossing the desert.
Head of the International Organization for Migration briefed the media on the health condition of the returnees.
We had a total of three medical cases, and we had also about nine females who are, we would regard them as vulnerable. Either they came with children or they were expectant.
The returnees are expected to go back to their various state of origin and reunite with their families, while those with medical condition will be hospitalized for evaluation and treatment. This is the fourth chartered flight conveying returnees to Nigeria from Libya this year. More are reportedly still stranded in that country.
The Association of Agricultural Products and Equipment Manufacturers in Nigeria today embarked on a peaceful protest to demand support from government for indigenous manufacturers. The protest, which took place in Lagos, was also an opportunity for members to correct some statements being circulated in the social media about Erisco Food Limited. Tekla Wilke reports.
The manufacturers noted that the Nigerian economy, which has been dominated by the energy sector, has in recent times witnessed tremendous progress. Some indigenous manufacturers say they are, however, groaning following what they term unfavorable business environment, especially in accessing forex, which they lamented is crippling production.
If I have a big factory, then I need big allocation. I have a small factory, then I only have to be given small dollars.
One of the founding members of the Association of Agricultural Products and Equipment Manufacturers in Nigeria, Eric Omofia, suggests that government needs to evaluate the foreign exchange policy, especially as it concerns indigenous manufacturers.
Nigeria must be a country to emulate among the community of nations.
He maintained that he will continue to remain patriotic and support indigenous business ventures if the government will review policies guiding the ease of doing business in Nigeria.
If we don't support President Buhari now, this country will be difficult to amend. I still have confidence that before President Buhari 8 years expire, Nigeria will be better.
Members of the association say Nigeria is greatly endowed with natural resources capable of feeding its citizens without external support from other nations.
If the CBN will only be supporting the foreigners, then we shall have to say no.
Members of the association say they will support the president's vision to turn Nigeria into an export-driven economy instead of import-reliant nation. In Lagos, Fekla Wilke, NTA News.
You're still watching NTA Network News from Lagos Network Center. We'll now take a break for some messages, after which the news continues from Abuja. Stay with us.
10 years ago, Globe predicted that the future lay in data. They laid a dedicated fiber optic ring around the country, seamlessly connecting to cities, suburbs, and towns. They created innovative, flexible, and highly affordable data plans. Then, Glo launched 4G LTE, data so clear and so fast that it will transform the way Nigerians communicate, work, learn, and play. They can listen to millions of music tracks, enjoy thousands of movies, play online video games, and even watch live TV. Their homes have become smart homes. This is the new speed of life.
Enjoy the fastest data speed plus free world-class content at 10 gigabytes for 2,500 naira and 24 gigabytes for 5,000 naira. Available in all Glo World outlets and Glo dealers. Welcome to the new speed of life.
This must be one of Mother Nature's greatest gifts. But there's something else it gives us. When we see such beauty, we want to share it with those we love. That's what LG wants you to see. Just what we see now, through our technology. LG OLED TV.
Hey, brother, there's an endless road to rediscover. The sky comes falling. There's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. Hey, what if I'm far from home? Oh, brother, I will hear you call. There's nothing in this world I wouldn't do.
Dead set, Jago! Dead set, Jago!
For the winner and you.
Some say Africa's golden era is gone. A time when great African kings and queens built their dreams into empires stretching across the continent and beyond. But we say a new era is upon us. A new set of African kings and queens are on the rise. Driven by the same wealth of character as the kings and queens before them. Building new empires of enterprise with the right partnership. So rise up wherever you are, new kings and queens of Africa. embrace your full potential and be proud of your heritage. Heritage Bank.
Thank you for remaining with NTN Network News. Financial analysts react to federal government strategy to secure foreign loans to fund the 2016 budget. Let's join Mopland Akok for this and more economic matters on Business News.
Thanks for joining us on Business News. I am Mopland Akok. Minister of Finance Kemi Adeosun has said the federal government will leave out local loans to go for foreign loans from international lending partners to fund the country's budget deficit.
The Honorable Minister of Finance is doing marvelously well on appropriate borrowing. Is not bad. You should not borrow for consumption. You should borrow for capital expenditure to develop the economy.
And we just need to support her in the financial management of the nation.
Still on the 2016 budget, the federal government has injected over 2.419 trillion naira into the economy out of the 6.06 trillion naira budgeted for 2016, as revealed by the 2017 to 2019 medium-term expenditure framework and fiscal paper. Recurrent expenditure alone, covering salaries, overheads, pensions and others, gobbled 1.479 billion naira between January and June, while domestic debt servicing stood at 609 billion naira and foreign debt servicing got 567 billion naira. Before we go, let's take a look at trading on the floor of the Nigerian Stock Exchange, which closed on a positive note with the All Share Index appreciating by 0.39%. That's what we have on our package. The news continues.
Former head of state General Yakubu Gowon will this Saturday lead concerned Nigerians to intercede for the corporate existence and stability of the nation in all spheres. General Gowon stated this at a media briefing ahead of the 20th anniversary of Nigeria Praise. Ruben Okala reports.
The need for Nigerians to believe in the efficacy of prayer as a solution to the nation's various challenges was the principal reason for the establishment of the Nigeria Praise in 1996. General Gowon says no amount of prayer is too much in the quest to put the nation in the path of peace and progress, urging Nigerians, irrespective of religious affiliations, to continue to pray considering the various challenges before the nation.
I know every effort is being done, you know, to deal with that particular problem. Let us give the government that time, but to make sure that we keep on reminding them that there is this problem and that they've got to do whatever they can to solve it. Criticize constructively, but just don't, condemn outright.
Apart from the one-day prayer and thanksgiving service at the National Crisis Center Abuja on Saturday, a book titled The Praying General will be presented to the public. In Abuja, Ruben Okala, NTN News.
With the commencement of the coronation process of Crown Prince Eheneden Eredewa as the 39th Oba of Benin, Steve Lonai Nwokolo reports on the life and times of the 38th Oba of Benin, the late Omonoba Enede Oko Akpolokpolo Oba Eredewa, who joined his ancestors last year.
The legendary and highly revered Royal Majesty Omonoba Enede Oko Akpolokpolo Oba Eredewa was born into the royal family of Benin Kingdom on the 22nd of June 1923 as the first son of Oba Akinzua II. As a young prince, Solomon attended the famous government college, Ibadan, and Yaba College, Lagos, before proceeding to the prestigious King's College, Cambridge, in London, where he studied law and administration.
He was the first university-trained king in Benin Kingdom.
With the wealth of experience as a technocrat, his father, Oba Akinzua, one of the most revered Oba that has ever sat at that throne, went to the ways of our flesh. And the mantle of leadership, Oba fell on his shoulders.
Prince Solomon ascended the throne of his forefathers on the 23rd of March, 1979. His reign of 37 years witnessed tremendous peace and tranquility, even as he brought monumental transformation and development to the Benin Kingdom.
The palace is a citadel of peace and tranquility.
He has been quite an alert Oba in addressing all the present problems of his people.
The great Ekpenua, Omonobanedo Uku Akpolopolo, Oba Edawa, transited to the great beyond on the 29th of April 2016, thereby paving the way for his son, the Crown Prince Ehenede Eldawa, to succeed him as the 39th Oba of Benin Kingdom. In Benin, Steve Lonai Nwaokolo, NTA News.
Up ahead, some global tidbits, sports updates, and weather prospects for Wednesday. Don't go away.
The focus this week on NTA's Tuesday Live is curbing the menace of kidnapping. NTA Tuesday Live, educating, incisive, and informative. Don't miss it. Join us.
The Benin Traditional Council invites members of the general public to the celebration of our heritage, the coronation ceremonies of His Royal Highness, Crown Prince Ambassador Ehenede Ediawa, Edaike Nuselu, as Omonobanedo Uku Akpolopolo, Oba of Benin. Saturday, 8th October 2016, the Edaike will be escorted by chiefs and people of Nuselu as he leaves Egwedaike Nuselu for Uedo. Monday, 10th October 2016, the Edaike will leave Ekoha for Usama Palace for a continuation of the coronation rituals. Tuesday, 18th October 2016, the Edaike will proceed to Use Village for the ceremony to choose a name. Thursday, 20th October 2016, the Edaike will leave Usama for Benin, proceeding through Isekere to Rukpota for the coronation ceremonies and presentation of staff of office by the governor of Edo State. On Friday, 21st October 2016, there will be a special Durbar presentation courtesy of His Eminence Alhaji Saad Abubakar III, Sultan of Sokoto, in honor of His Royal Majesty the King. Sunday, 23rd October 2016, the Omonoba will have a Thanksgiving worship at Holy Aosa Cathedral. Come, let's celebrate.
Chimdi Martin DBC is here with the Global Tidbits.
From New England Journal of Medicine indicate that malaria death rate in sub-Saharan Africa has